Hi, I'm Eric DeMatt, and welcome back to Let's Play Spawn Armageddon for the GameCube. I figured out what we're supposed to do. We have to kill everything in this room, all the waves, and I went through again, so I have a decent amount of health, so I cannot immediately die. We're going to deal with these angel people as if we were cowards, because they can't come up here. Just gonna stand here and shoot our chains down at them. Fair? No. The only way to succeed? Oh yeah. Sorry, I'm not talking much. Can't see the enemy. Well, that's a dead space station crew. Next wave. Do what that journal entry is if we got it, if we technically already got it. Further, equipped from Stone Cannon. Yeah, we know all of that one already. Well, the space station crew's halo above it is above it. A shield surrounds them. The shield can only be penetrated by hell power attacks. Touching the shield causes searing pain and damage to hell.
Remaining security team, report to control room.
Nope, no, leave me alone, please. Okay, and we're back up. Finish the Castlevania and, Netflix show, it's very good. Yeah, thanks for the ammo, but could you drop health? That would be a lot more useful. Okay. Next wave.
Remaining security team, report to control room.
I think we're gonna get have something. there. He's going to be our first turn. Ow, that laser. Magic. Still got some standard angels down there, right? Where's the rest of the space station crew? I know there are a few of them down there. There's one. Lovely.
Remaining security team.
What have you learned? Space station crew. When the Halo starts to circle the space station crew, regular attacks will cause damage. However, the Halo becomes a deadly weapon and can fly rapidly towards a target. Cool, so they're like Tron.
Report to control room.
Oh shit, how do you get up here? Okay, trick them off. Good. I like the music. Hiding. Let's see what we learned about angel predators. Like other angels, predators are strong against projectile attacks but weak against hand-to-hand moves. They are sometimes far too quick for an attacker to strike at close range of weapons. Thank you. I can hold this easily defensible position forever. This is your first. Anything left in here to kill? Yeah, there's a Ninja Warrior. And that's our exit. Finally done with Angel Station. Lovely. Turn off this weapon.
How am I supposed to shut this down?
Hit it a lot.
You don't.
Redeemer.
That weapon will put an end to thousands of years of warfare.
Since when has it been the duty of angels to completely obliterate anybody who might rebel against them?
You fool! That has been our purpose from the dawn of time. Sodom, Gomorrah, Jericho, the list is endless.
You call that warfare?
Was Al Simmons never involved in a preemptive strike?
Ooh.
He would understand our purpose.
I am Al Simmons, damn you!
Not for long.
We get to fight the Redeemer again. Nice. Mission complete. Fledgling, but we got all four comic covers. Ugh. One more mission left. Mission 23.
The end of the world. One hurdle remains before Spawn can free the Earth and himself. The ultimate form of the Redeemer, the Metatron.
Let's power up. These things. These babies. And trust the old shotgun. Let's do this! Yeah, last mission! That'll be how to stop playing Spawn again. Exactly. I like this game, but slow motion cutscenes, they're all running through the whole space thing.
Now, you're exactly where we want you.
Oh, yeah, oh. It's some kind of big scorpion thing. Well, it's... Yes, it is. Cool. Blades. Don't know what those mean, but he has them. Let's see if we have any encyclopedia knowledge of the Metatron. Nope, we go right here. Going well. He has a lot of health, but he's not that hard. This form, at least. That's a madcap ammo. Good. Thank you. Second form. It looks like you walked right out of a Final Fantasy game. Come on! Yes! Minigun for the win! Yeah! Ooh. Another full fancy cutscene. So we blew up the giant super weapon.
It is done. The hellhole is closed.
Now it's time for Malbosia to fulfill his side of the bargain.
He won't.
I'm afraid that won't be happening, my friend.
Of course.
What?
You were promised your humanity if the weapon was never fired again. But indeed it was.
Shit. Wanda.
They fucked us again. New entries added to concept gallery. Didn't you? Now for the credits. Needless to say, Angel Station's confusingness aside, I loved this game. This game was amazing. I had so much goddamn fun playing this. It's, as a fan of Spawn anyway, it was good, but as a game, it's just solid. It's a solid third-person high-octane action game. I really enjoyed it. My only criticism is I would have liked to see more characters in the comics making an appearance. I'm not pretending we should fight Malbolgia. I mean, Malbolgia was stupid enough as it is. But more bosses from the game, instead of like spider tanks and Reaver and things that aren't in the comic, like bring in, I don't know, Overkill or Overt Kill as you call the comic. Bring him in. Bring in. The curse boss of them. The other Philibak brothers, Violator's family, the Vandalizer, the Vindicator, the Vacillator. Like, more than just dredge some of those are bosses in the even bosses in the I mean, it was fun. It was definitely fun, but I would have liked more of the comics to show up.
said. That's about it. Taco Buddy. Taco Buddy? Taco. Okay. Taco Buddy. Wait. Weird ass name. The graphics were great for the time. Not that great now, but I mean, I was too focused on having fun playing it. I never noticed those. A few too many necroplasm powers that never ended up being used. Because you weren't entirely sure what they were for. Didn't really use necroplasm much except for those, except when things got desperate is when I busted out the necroplasm bolts. Weapons loadout was cool, I liked it. Never got much use out of the brimstone cannon, it was too goddamn slow and heavy. Yeah, Kevin Michael Richardson, David Saul Belove is Malbolgia, Redeemer and Space Station crew were John DiMaggio, Aldrich. Violet of Stephen J. Bloom, the assassin, the Gregory Hunter, Aaron Fitzgerald. It was Sash. Lamon. Oh, Marilyn Manson song. Obviously, that makes all make sense. For Spawn. It's a good Spawn thing. I liked it. Sagor was a little frustrating, but Metatron was surprisingly easy to fight. Now, after the credits, we're going to have a look at the concept stuff, encyclopedia stuff, and of course, comic covers that we've unlocked throughout the game. I did not get all of them, I'm aware. If you want to see all of them, go out on your own and find and look them up. Play the game, I highly recommend that. It's really good. Maybe you can figure out Angel Station better than I did. Because you're probably not as dumb as I am. Yeah, it's tested by a man named Narciso Angel. Cool. A Todd McFarlane Entertainment and Todd McFarlane Productions co-production. The Todd McFarlane worked with Todd McFarlane on this. Wonderful.
Stop.
I almost done these credits? Looks like it. There's a reason why King Arthur, that has a long ass credits, man. And there we go. Let's have a look at some bonus material. Encyclopedia. The Metatron. Traditionally the voice of God, the Metatron is actually a super powerful form. In a super powerful form that the elemental fire that comprises the Redeemer can take when bolstered by the power of Angel's Nature. Since the Metatron is comprised of pure elemental fire, it can take any form it chooses. When it encounters Spawn, it chooses a form in response to Spawn's enormous potential for destruction. After taking damage, the Metatron activates a shield to protect itself while it recharges. The Razor drones it releases while shielded will often drop power-ups. Destroy the drones quickly to end the recharging time. When the Metatron is in humanoid form and harnessing energy, he is vulnerable, especially to heavier attacks. That's every entry. Every entry in the game. It's an Angel Hunter. Here's our chains. I'm not entirely sure what that is. I think it's one of the angels. A really cool looking idea for Angel that they should have gone with. That's a Berserker. He came out pretty much looking like he did. Claw Demons. Claw Demon. Wind's Office. The Cathedral. Imps. Possible concept for an imp. Yep, those things. The hell leeches. Flying imps. Flame demon. They were cool. That's our city that we tried to save from hell forces. Don't know what that is, but looks like it's something in hell. Some kind of building. Spawn city. Not entirely sure. Probably the city again. The city again. The city from the rooftops showing off spires and stuff. Cathedral. Cathedral. I think that was the Angel Station. Spawn City layout. Warehouse District. Angel Station, I think. Spawn City, the church that's the center of Spawn City. Jade Wynn's Office. Angel Station. The Angel Office. No idea. Some stained glass windows. City. No idea. There are a lot of these. Wow, that's a lot of them. Look at the comic gallery. Spot number one. Spot number two. No, that's not. I don't know which comic this one is. I know it's not Spawn number 2, because I actually have a copy of Spawn number 2 around here somewhere. It's a nice cover. Spawn posing, doing the Spider-Man pose. Spawn with some guns. Spawn being beaten by Overkill. Spawn on a rooftop. Spawn and medieval Spawn having been killed by Angela. That time Spawn had a crossover with Cerberus. That was an interesting time. Spawn fighting Chapel. Spawn having killed Violator. Medieval Spawn having killed Violator. Spawn unmasked. Can't remember exactly what I think Spawn teamed up with a Houdini guy
I did read that comic. I knew exactly what happened. It didn't spawn on fire. Spawn bleeding necroplasm from his face. No idea. Spawn, kind of boring cover. Spawn on the church. Spawn in a swamp. Spawn having beaten up some muggers. Spawn with a torn up cape. It's when he got his costume evolved, and he got the massive cast and the spiky gauntlet and started looking a little dumb. Spawn protecting an abused child. The Violator running through the sewers. That's all the comics we got. Missed all the others. So, I've been Merrick D'Amato, and I'll see you all on the next Let's Play, which might actually be Chronicles of Narnia. The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe for the GameCube, because I will need to save state that game to be able to complete it with a minimum of frustration. So until then, see ya. Hi, thanks for watching. This has been played and recorded by me, Merrick D'Amato. The art was by Rafael Agrona. You can find a link to their commission page in the description below. And if you like this video and want to see more like it, like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and see you all next time. Ciao!